Right, okay, now this little video is a moon jar I've just done. I found a piece of clay in a bag that has dried out a little bit, and it was a bit stiffer than normal, so I thought I'd make the best of it and throw a moon jar for you. So here's the moon jar. Right, just to finish the morning off, I've got a lump of clay here that was sort of a third of a bag that was left over from a few weeks ago. And it's gone a bit hard, so I thought I'd take advantage of it, because obviously moon jars throw better with harder clay. The stiffer the clay you can handle, the better. It saves you having to use a heat gun. So this is the first moon jar back since the layoff. Stiff. Leave a deep enough base in the bottom so I can lift it off. It's amazing how the muscle memory works. If you've been throwing for a number of years, even though you can have like almost 2 months off, which is literally like riding a bike. Muscle memory is still there. This is about 4 kilos of clay. Way clay. Collar it up so you get it taller. Finger over the top to stop it from going sort of like a petal shape at the end. So if you curl your finger over the top, it stops that happening. Press the rim. Slightly going out, it's not slightly out of centre here, so the rim's wobbling a little bit. That's because the clay is, although I've wedged it, it's sort of partially dried out. So let's see if we get it a little bit taller. Last collar up. Finger over the top. Now start to just belly it out. Here's my hand to begin with. When you're throwing out and throwing up to the top, it's always best to throw right to the rim, because what happens is, as I'm stretching down here, it's sort of always almost uneven, and the top will start to wobble. So if you bring it back up, don't worry about it. If you bring it back up and carry on throwing to the edge, it comes back into centre. So I'm just trying to show you now. If you're throwing it out, you see the top starting to go. See it wobbling there? That's because it's a different thickness where my hands are. But once we get back up to the top, we'll just go steady. It re-centres. actually starts to go out a little bit when you're throwing it. You're not throwing it wrong or incorrectly. It's just the torque and the different thickness as you're going up. Kind of sort of difficult to explain. So I just start to use a, I use the a rib now. This is just a 6-inch bat cut in half with a couple of holes drilled in it. Does the job. Just doing the transition from the base to the wall inside. And then we work on the walls. See, it's gone out of centre again. Don't worry about that because it will come back. Tell the sort of courage of your conviction and faith in what you can do. Still a bit out of true, but there you go, it'll do. My first moon jar in about 2 months. Doing here is I'm just evening the thickness out and it'll make this top wobble a little bit, but so long as this bit here is the same thickness from the shoulder into the neck, what I do is trim that little bit off. And there are some people that never have to deal with this, but I'm not that good at throw. Do demonstrations and people say you make it look so easy. I don't find it easy at all, I find it quite difficult. But I like the challenge. I think life would be quite boring if you only ever did the safe things in life. I suppose that's why people jump out of airplanes, isn't it? And go deep sea diving. Excitement. It's exciting, especially this weather with the damp roads. You can't see it, but I'm working on the transition from the base into the wall at the bottom here, getting it smooth. that's it. Moon jar done. First one done for a number of months. Getting back into it now, slowly but surely, so that come January the 1st, we can sort of hit the ground running and prep all the work for next year's shows. Okay, see you next time.